How are we doing today, good people? This is Otto with the final video in my countdown series for my crowdfunding campaign. That Otto symbol that I just showed was from a trash can. When I came to Berkeley to go to grad school, all the recycling and trash cans in my neighborhood had my name on it, which was pretty cool. Just cycling through some images of this dude. So I'm going to keep this video pretty simple and just kind of talk a bit while this spiral gets poured. I first started using the pendulum back in 2003. I've been doing a lot of pouring of paint, splashing of paint, and just kind of exploring. I had been a musician before becoming an artist, and I'm pretty ADHD and don't have a very... I'll say the traditional education process doesn't work well for my mind. And so when I was studying music, the best thing that I could do was just follow what made me happy. So I had a living room filled with instruments, a drum set, bass guitar, a couple of one acoustic, one electric guitar, keyboards. And I would just go from instrument to instrument, just play all night. Play one until I got bored and then move on to the next. And eventually I got pretty decent at all of them. And when I started to try to teach guitar lessons, I used to say the cosmic guitar lesson is buy an instrument and hang out with it. Because I feel like the instruments, after so many years of being made for humans, fit our hands and our bodies incredibly well. And they will sort of show you what to do. So when I started to become an artist or try to become an artist, I wanted to let the paint show me what it wanted to do. So that meant a lot of pouring of paint and, you know, just exploring. I got whatever free house paint and whatever else I could get my hands on. Made tons of messes and terrible, terrible art. And eventually I read Jackson Pollock in a conversation with Max Ernst. I studied a lot of different artists. I'd been trying to find some order to balance out the chaos of my poured paintings, and I tried figures and geometry and all kinds of other stuff, and nothing was working. And then I read this conversation between Jackson Pollock and Max Ernst. Max Ernst is a famous surrealist painter from Germany. And Max Ernst was, so they say, afraid of the blank canvas. So he used to take plant matter and ink it up and press it onto the canvas. And then he would do like surrealist landscapes from those pressings. And he told Pollock an easy way to start a painting was to poke a hole in a can and hang it from a string. I wonder if instead of hanging it from a string, he just used the can. But I took that to heart, and I attached the string to the ceiling of my studio, and the first spiral came out, and I had a tremendous revelation that that's the thing that I was looking for to bring some order to the chaos. And that sparked a 20-year journey of using the pendulum, and I finally have reached a place where I feel like I use the tool very effectively for what my vision is trying to communicate. Now, pours like this, I think, are a little more pragmatic, a little more scientific and neat. You know, they're super cool to watch, but it feels a little bit more like a magic trick. It's just kind of a neat thing that anyone can do once they know how to do it, you know? But I take that spiral and use it for my own vision. I really love the way that it symbolizes or feels like an echo of the galaxy, how the vertical line connects to the horizontal plane. I feel like the spiral is an amazing symbol of how time moves. It's not just a linear path. It circles back on itself, and we might feel like we're growing for a while, and then we feel like we're regressing for a while. And it just really embodies so many concepts that I am interested in my life and in my work. All right, well, we'll see you next time. I'm going to start a different video process after this. Thanks for tuning in. Appreciate you.